guys, it's me, and today I'm here with my March DBR. Each month I set myself 5 reading challenges, and I, in my DBR videos, just pick one book to fit each challenge, and I try to read them in a month. These challenges are basically just some goals, like reading books out of my comfort zone, or sequels, but it just keeps me accountable to like get books off my DBR, and not just like reread books or read library books. So, like, even though all of those things are great, and I still want to do those things in a month, I also just want to make an effort to make as much of a dent in my physical TBR as possible. I don't know why I'm explaining all of this so much, but let's just get started. The first challenge being to read a book out of my comfort zone, and for that I have picked Becoming by Michelle Obama. This is just a memoir by Michelle Obama, and I bought this when this came out, and I still haven't read this. I bought this because Michelle Obama is an amazing woman, and I just want to learn more about her, and I've also heard amazing reviews about this book, and I haven't read it yet because it's intimidating. It's non-fiction, which I don't read often, and it's also quite big, and I don't know, I'm scared of this book, which I'm doing it this month. Hold me accountable, I'm reading this book this month. I really want to. Then the next challenge is to read a sequel, and for that I have picked another big book. That's The House of Hades by Rick Riordan, which is the fourth book in the Heroes of Olympus series, which is a spin-off series to the Percy Jackson series. And Percy Jackson is a middle grade series, which is Greek mythology, like retold, but like demigods and adventure funness. And then this is a sequel series which also follows Roman mythology. It's more towards the YA side rather than the middle grade side, because the characters are older in this than Percy Jackson. I'm really loving this series. Like, I started this a while ago, but and I've loved the first three books. But for some reason, I just haven't gotten around to reading this one and the last one. This being the reason, the size, this is a 600-page book. The next challenge is to read a new book. So that's a book I bought recently, and in February I bought Yes, No, Maybe So by Rebecca Batali and Aisha Said. I think that's how you pronounce that name. I'm so sorry I got one. But this was a February release, and it's about two teens who end up like going on a political campaign and falling in love. And yeah, it's Rebecca Batali, who was my favorite author, or my favorite book. So that's the main reason why I want to read this. And then the second to last challenge is to read a TBR fed. So this is a book that's been on my TBR for over a year. And for that, I have picked The Iron Daughter by Julie Kagawa. It is a lineup of the first two books in the Iron Fae series. I've already read the first one, which is The Iron King. I'll be reading the second one, which is an assault hunt. I think these books are both like around 200 pages. The first book was a very easy read and very fun as well and quick. So I'm expecting the same from the second one. I want to put this off my TBR because this is one of the books that has been there the longest. And yeah, I just want to be able to say that I've finished this behemoth of a book, even though it's technically two books in one. The Iron King is about a girl who one day comes home and her brother is like acting really strange. And then her like best friend comes over because it's like her birthday and he comes to celebrate. And turns out that best friend is actually a fae, has been protecting her all this time, and a little brother has been replaced like a changeling, and our main character apparently is a princess to this fairy king, like an illegitimate princess to the fairy king, and she now has to go into the fairy worlds to find back her brother, basically. But there's more to it because she's a little illegitimate child, so stuff happens, and yeah. For my last challenge, I picked a book out of my TBR jar, which is this Harry Potter from Go Mystery Minis box, because I have nothing else. Also, still haven't glued this, even though I said that in January that I needed to do that. But, well, I have all the books in here. I went through it, I think a couple of days ago, and I refolded these because they were like all like unfolded and like a mess, and it was like filled till the top, but now it's not. And I took out the books I read in February, so this should be the most up-to-date it has been. So yeah, let's just grabble one out. Not what I have to read. I would just say I own a couple of sequels, like books I haven't read yet. So those come up, I have to pick up like the first book in that series or like where I last left off. Not the exact book as well, because I could pick like the last book in the Vampire Academy series and like, have to read the whole series. Like, that's not it. I'm just gonna read the first one. Okay. I am picking this one, which is very neatly folded, which is nice. I'm trying to. Shadow Kiss, the Rochelle Meet. I made a Vampire Academy joke for. Wait, Shadow Kiss is the third book in the Vampire Academy series, but I'll be reading the first one, A Vampire Academy by Rochelle Meet, for a couple of reasons. Because I don't know if you noticed, but besides this one, these books are quite big. Like, this is the shortest one of all, and this is like still like over 400 pages, which isn't a lot to some people, but like it also isn't short. And then this is close to 500 pages, this is close to 600 pages, and then this one is about 250 pages, rough math. So I wanted a shorter book because I knew this was ambitious because the big books. This comes from my short book pile, which is under 250 pages. I've also been wanting to start the series, but I haven't really been able to put it in any of my categories because it's from November, so it isn't really a new book. Like, at least not the most new book. And then it also isn't an old book, obviously. And it also isn't out of my comfort zone, it also isn't a sequel. So, but I have been wanting to start this series, and I love vampires, and I know this is like a quintessential YA vampire novel. So I've been wanting to read this series for a while, and I got it for my birthday. And since then I've been wanting to, but just I haven't gotten around to it. And oh, this is perfect. If I have time in a month, I might put an effort onto reading up until the third book. Because the second book is also pretty short. So, but I don't know how much time I'm gonna have in a month. But I'm really excited about this. Those are the five books I'm reading in March. Let me know in the comments down below what you thought of any of these books if you read them. Also, what are some of the books you're planning to read in the month of March? But yeah, I guess I'll see you guys next time. Goodbye. Here I am again, the same old situation. Why does the gap thing have to be so complicated?